Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunke and welcome to the x86 assembly course. So we'll start with the working with the high level language. So the high level languages are C, C++, Java, etc. So we have a source code file named example.c. C preprocessor will preprocess that code file and example.i file will be generated. After that, C compiler will convert that file into assembly code file and example.s file will be generated. After that, assembler will convert that file into object code file and then example.o file will be generated. After that, linker with the help of other object code file and object code libraries will convert that file into an executable file such as example.exe. So when you execute the program, that example.exe file is currently stored in a secondary storage such as hard disk drive. Then when you execute that program, the loader will load runtime objects, modules and libraries, and that file will be loaded into the main memory known as a RAM, and the file will be allocated a process address space. Now we'll look at the C programming basics. So we'll start with the Hello World program. So to perform exercises, we need Windows XP Edition. I have installed Windows XP on VMware platform. You can use VMware or VirtualBox. And then install Microsoft Visual Studio 2008 Express Edition with C++. Okay, so we'll look at the Hello World program. This is the Hello World program. Let's look what is happening there. The first line is hash include stdio.h. Okay, so this is a preprocessor command which tells C compiler to include stdioh files before going to actual compilation, right? After that, integer main, open bracket, close bracket, and then starting of a curly bracket. That means main function where the program execution begins. And the curly bracket tells compiler that main program's body has been started. Then next statement is printf hello world /n. So this function is available in C in stdio.h file, which causes hello world to be displayed on a screen. Okay, then next statement is return 0 and closing of a curly bracket. That means it is telling that it terminates the main function and returning the value 0. Okay, now let's run this program. To run this program, we need to click build and build solution. As we can see, we have successfully compiled the program. Now let's run it using the play symbol. Okay, so the program has been executed successfully, but we didn't see any output. Why? Because the program exited with the return 0. So what we'll do, we'll place a breakpoint there. What is a breakpoint? The breakpoint means when we click here, the program will stop execution here, so we can see the result. Click on play icon. After that, click on this, and as we can see, hello world has been printed on a screen. Now let's look at some C programming basics. So the semicolon means it's statement terminator. That means this statement has been ended and now the new statement will start. Slash star, this is comment, slash stars means whatever we return inside this will be ignored by a compiler. So this is comment is ignored by the compiler and will not be processed. Remember this thing, C is a case sensitive. So small abc is different than capital A small bc. So integer break if, there are some keywords in C language, so we can't use these keywords as a constants or a variable. So now let's look at the data types. So data type is used for to declaring variables or functions of a different type. So types of a variable determine how much space occupies in a storage and how the bit pattern is interpreted. Okay, so type of a function specifies the type of a function's return value. The data type we have already seen is an int int. It is for integer, a whole number. It is generally 2 or 4 bytes. Now let's look at the variables. So what is a variable? Variable is a name given to the storage area. So variable has a specific type which determines the size and a layout of a variable's memory and set of operations that can be applied to that variable, right? So this is the way we can define the variable type, variable name equals value. So this is an example of a variable integer num1, or we can initialize the variable using the other format such as integer num2 equals 0. So this is all I have planned for this video. If you have any doubts, any questions, you can mail me on vikram@vmaskers.com, or you can tweet me at vikramsalunke20. Thank you.